well.
Oh yeah.
When things get difficult and don't seem to be going your way, it can be easy to fall in the trap of sharing your misery with other people who are miserable as well.
Yes.
We think that if we hear about other people's misery, it will help us feel better about our own situation. But it really doesn't. You heard the saying, misery loves company. Well, so does negativity. Negativity is like a cancer, always looking for new victims. It will rob you of your energy and it will severely affect you and your family.
Yeah.
Negativity serves absolutely no purpose except to breed more negativity. Start today to unchain yourself from the bandage of negativity. Never bring negativity into your family. Stay away from people who breed it. And fill your thoughts with positive thoughts and seek out people who have positive influences on others. Do this today and every day and watch the positive impact it's going to have on you and your family going forward in the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
We also have many examples of both positive and negative attitudes. And let us see what we learn from Exodus 32, verses 19 to 22. Exodus 32, 19 to 22. We read about how Moses reacted in anger when he saw the children of Israel worshipping a golden calf. When Moses approached the camp and saw the calf and dancing, his anger burned and he threw the tablets out of his hands, breaking them to pieces at the foot of the mountain. And he took the calf the people had made and burned it in the fire. Then he ground it to a powder and scattered it on the water and made the Israelites drink it. He said to Aaron, "What did these people do to you that you led them into such great sin? Do not be angry, my Lord," Aaron answered. "You know how prone these people are to evil." Moses was so angry that he broke the two tablets of the Ten Commandments. What lesson do we learn from Moses' action? First, if he had not broken the Ten Commandments in anger, the provision of the commandments against idolatry would have condemned the Jews completely. And secondly, his anger gave him the boldness to burn the golden calf and compel the Jews to drink the water containing the dust of their golden calf. If you are not angry, you can correct people. But you have to be pushed to the wall to stand your ground. You have to be pushed to the wall to say, "No, it's no." And you will damn the consequences. You do not care who you offend, because you know that you are fighting God's battle.
Amen.
But if you compromise, you compromise your ministry, you are done for. And that is what we are saying, that there are sometimes you just have to develop that anger. And that is what we call the positive anger, where you have to correct something that is going on. And then in Numbers 2, chapter 20, verses 2 to 12, here Moses was provoked again. As we leaders are always faced with such provocation and tempted to react either rationally or irrationally. Now, there was no water for the community and the people gathered in opposition to Moses and Aaron. They quarreled with Moses and said, "If only we had died when our brothers fell dead before the Lord. Why did you bring this Lord's community into this wilderness, that we and our livestock should die here? Why did you bring us up here out of Egypt to this terrible place? It has no grain or figs, grapevines or pomegranates, and there's no water to drink." Moses and Aaron went from the assembly to the entrance to the tent of meeting and fell face down. And the glory of the Lord appeared to them. The Lord said to Moses, "Take the staff, and you and your brother Aaron gather the assembly together. Speak to that rock before their eyes, and it will pour out its water. You will bring out water of the rock for the community, so they and their livestock can drink." I will repeat that statement again. I want you to follow me. He said, "Take the staff." This is the instruction. "Take this staff, and you and your brother Aaron gather the assembly together. Speak,
mm-hmm.
speak
yes.
to that rock before their eyes. And it will pour out water, it will bring water out of the rock for the community so that they and their livestock can drink. So Moses took the staff from the Lord's presence, just as he commanded him. And he and his brother Aaron gathered their servants together in front of the rock. And Moses said to them, "Listen, you rebels, must we bring you water out of this rock?" Then Moses raised his arm and struck the rock. Twice with his staff. Of course, water gushed out, but something was missing. And the community and the others drank. But the Lord said to Moses and Aaron, "Because you did this, because you did not trust me enough to honor me as holy in the sight of the Israelites, you will not bring this community into the land I gave them." Did you get the message? Because you did not obey me. What did I say? Speak to the rock. But Moses was enraged. He allowed his anger, he allowed these people to force him.
Yes.
To anger his people. Wah, wah. And who is the rock? Jesus is the rock. And he hid Jesus. You see what anger can do? When we can no longer defend ourselves, this is what anger can do for us. We have to be very, very careful. When we cannot tolerate further insult and control our temper, this is a real lesson for all leaders.
Yes.
Never to allow anybody to provoke you while performing your lawful responsibility.
Yes, Lord.
By feeble-minded people under your commands, as you will end up like Moses, by disobeying God because of these rebellious children of Israel.
Yes.
He brought them out of Egypt. He led them through the Red Sea. But he allowed their rebellious attitude to deny him the pleasure and honor of leading them into the promised land.
Yeah.
We all want to get there.
Yes.
But you must very, very be careful. Never allow the people that are not ready to go there to stop you from getting there. They will antagonize you. They will criticize you for something you don't know anything about.
Yes.
They put all the blames on you. It is for you now to stand your ground. Tell them. The brothers of Joseph were sensitive to the dreams of their brother and were filled with jealousy and anger because of the love their father Jacob had for him. And their negative attitude led them to sell him into slavery. As we also read in Genesis chapter 37, 26 to 28, Judah said to his brothers, "What will we gain by killing our brother?" They all conspired. They said, "Let us kill him." Are you sleeping? "Let us kill him. Instead of hurting him, let's sell him to those Ishmaelite traders. After all, he is our brother, our own flesh and blood." And his brother agreed. So when the Ishmaelites, who were Midianite traders, came by, Joseph's brother pulled him out of the cistern and sold him to them for 20 pieces of silver. They sold their brother for 20 pieces of silver. And the traders took him to Egypt. If it had not been for Judah, they would have killed their brother, just like anger led Cain to kill Abel, to become the first murderer in human history. Prophet Elisha was another example of how leaders and servants of God can be tempted to react negatively when insulted or provoked by some miserable or undisciplined people. We also read in 2 Kings 2, 23-24, "Then he went up," that is Elisha talking now, "up from there to Bethel. As he was going up, by the way, young lads came out from the city and mocked him and said to him, 'Go up, you bald head. Go up, you bald head.' When he looked behind him and saw them, he became enraged.